Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to properly install most third-party apps that you download from websites. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 600 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So a common way to install third-party apps on your Mac is to download them from their official websites, and then you end up with what's called a disk image. When you open that disk image, it looks just like a folder, but it's a little different. And then you'll see that application, and you also see something that looks like the applications folder. And usually there's an arrow going from one to the other. Let me show you what to do in this situation. So as an example, I'm going to download two third-party web browsers. One is Google Chrome. And when I go to the official Google Chrome download page, I have a download Chrome button. The first time you do this, it's going to ask you for permission to download from this site. So you say OK, and then it downloads it to the downloads folder. Same thing with Firefox. When you go to Firefox, you get a download now button. You click on that. It may or may not ask you for permission, and then it will download to your downloads folder. I'm just using Firefox and Chrome as examples. These could be all sorts of different types of apps provided by third parties at their official websites. So they could be games, they could be office apps, they could be utilities, anything. Just remember to only ever download software from sites that you trust, and make sure you're downloading from the official site of the app. Often the app might be something you trust, but is the website you're downloading from something you trust? That's why you always make sure that you go to the developer's site and download from their links, not from some other site that just lists a bunch of apps to download. In Safari, you can click on downloads here and you can see your recent downloads. You may also have the downloads folder in your dock, in which case you can click it and see the files you've downloaded. But if you don't, you can just go to Finder and go to Go and then Downloads, and it will take you to your downloads folder. Now these files don't look like apps because they're not. You can see the file extension here, .dmg. If you're not seeing file extensions, you can always select the file, use Command I, and then you could see the full file name there and see that it is a disk image. So what is a disk image? Well, disk image is a type of file that pretends to be a drive, like a USB thumb drive that you plug into your Mac or an external drive. But it's not a disk, but a disk image. Basically the contents of an external disk, but stored inside a file. When you double click on one of these to open it, it will take a little while to open. You may see it say verifying as it verifies the contents to make sure that the download was intact. And then it will open up in a new Finder window here. And it looks just like a folder in the Finder. But there's something a little different going on. If we look in the Finder in the sidebar and you look for locations, you may have to hit the Show button next to Locations. You'll see a list of all your drives. Here's my main hard drive. Here's an external drive I've connected, and my Time Machine drive that I've connected. And you can see there's that Google Chrome disk image. That only appears there once I've opened it up. So what do you do now? Well, a lot of people jump right into running the application. After all, the application's right there. You just double click on it. And in most cases, it will launch and run. But this is not the proper way to do it, because what's going to happen is eventually you're going to close this disk image and it will look like the app disappeared completely from your computer. Instead, you want to install it. Installing it is really easy. This is called a drag and drop install. And it's made easier by the fact that you have this applications folder here. This is a shortcut to your applications folder, also known as an alias. Notice the little curved arrow at the bottom. So if I were to double click on this, this will open up my applications folder. So this is a shortcut to get to that applications folder. And what it's doing there is to make it easier for me to install this app. I could drag this app to my applications folder. Matter of fact, you can drag it to the sidebar right here to your applications folder. But I can also drag it to the shortcut to the applications folder. So it's just a way to make it easier to get this file to your applications folder. So to properly install Google Chrome, I would just drag and drop in there. Now each app looks a little different. If I double click on Firefox here, it will open up that disk image. Now you can see in the Finder sidebar here, I've got that Google Chrome disk image. I also have a Firefox disk image. Now look at what Firefox does. They do a nice color background to this disk image location. They have the app here. They have this little curvy colored arrow. and there's the shortcut to the Applications folder. So again, I can drag this to the Applications folder or any other way to get into the Applications folder that I want. This is just the most convenient route. And when I drag it in there, it will copy this application into my Applications folder. Now let's check out my Applications folder. When I look at that and I look through the contents, I will find Firefox right there, and I will find Google Chrome also right there. So it successfully installed those in my Applications folder. Next thing I want to do is I want to close these disk images. I don't need them opened anymore. They've served their purpose. So I can click the little eject button next to each one in the sidebar. Now I've closed those out. Now to run these applications, I can simply double click on them here inside of the Applications folder. I can also go to Launchpad. I could search for them there and I could click on them to run them. I could also just use Spotlight, so Command Space, and then search for the app and hit return to run it there. But a lot of times we want these in our dock. To get them into the dock, all you need to do is with the Applications folder, just drag and drop them into the left side of the dock. That's before the first line on the right there. So drag them in here, and I can drag this one here, and now I can close the Applications folder and I can run these applications from the dock. Now what about what's left in my Downloads folder? If I look in the Downloads folder there, I can see those disk images. I don't need them anymore. So I can select those and drag them to the trash and get rid of them. And I'm always asked about uninstalling apps as well. As far as uninstalling a third-party app is concerned, you should always check the support website for that app to see if there are any special uninstall instructions. But in most cases, if you installed the app using this drag and drop method, then uninstalling it is just as easy. Just drag from the Applications folder into the trash and it removes the app. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.